Hey guys, what is up? Welcome to my channel. For today's video, I have another holiday makeup release review. I'm going to be reviewing the new Hourglass Ambient Lighting palettes that come out every year for the holiday season. So if you want to see my thoughts on these, as well as get comparisons between the two and all of that good stuff, then just keep watching. Hi guys, if you're new here, my name is Morgan. I am a product knowledge enthusiast. I just love knowing anything and everything about all the new makeup on the market and sharing my thoughts with you guys. I let you know my most recent shopper drop that I was planning on picking up both of the ambient lighting palettes for you guys so that I could compare them and really show you guys what is up with these. Right now, both of these palettes as well as a third palette are available on the Hourglass website, and I believe one of these palettes and the deeper trio is available at Sephora right now. So I picked these up from the Hourglass website. I got them so quickly because I paid for overnight shipping and they really came very fast. Even I'm impressed. It really was overnight. Normally it takes a second night to get to me, so great shipping on Hourglass's part. And I will say, if you are going to order these, the powders themselves are quite soft and they can break easily. I do recommend ordering from Hourglass because they pack their makeup much more protected. There's like those paper straws everywhere, and it just was very, very safe. I felt like my powders weren't going to break, whereas Sephora, you know, they pack them with like two pieces of paper. My stuff breaks in the mail all the time from Sephora. So as in terms of getting your product in one piece, I think Hourglass shipping is a lot more reliable. So let's get into the holiday releases themselves. For this holiday season, Hourglass released two palettes that are typical to their normal holiday edit palettes, and they also released a trio that is catered to deeper skin tones. So quickly, I want to talk about this trio right here. I didn't pick it up because I wasn't going to use it. I couldn't get it to work for me no matter what. But this is called the Ambient Lighting Palette. It's Volume 3. So they've come out with two. I use Volume 1 in my makeup kit. I absolutely love it. And this palette is significantly darker than both of the palettes that came out in this holiday launch. Honestly, really excited about it. It looks really, really good for deeper skin tones. I know Victoria James and Glam Girl Chelsea both said that they were going to review it, and they have deeper skin tones than myself, so definitely subscribe to them and check out their reviews on this. I can't wait to watch them to see how this palette works out. And surprisingly, right now there are no other holiday kits available, just the palettes. Normally Hourglass does release other makeup kits of like lipsticks and other products that they have in their line. I'm sure that might be later to come in the holiday season, but these three palettes are here now. So I picked up both, as you can see, of the lighting edit palettes. I pick these up every year. I love these palettes, but if you pick them up every year like me, they definitely are starting to get repetitive. But let's take a deep dive into these. So right now, I'm assuming these are limited edition because the website says this is going to be available for the holiday season, which is starting right now. Well, the holiday season is starting in the makeup world, not like the real world, but anyways. So both of these are going to be $80. These are called the Universe palettes. The name Universe and the design of the palette are inspired by the unique swirled texture of powder. So for the lighter one right here, it's going to channel a celestial glow. And for the deeper one, this is a swirl texture of the bronzers, which is handmade using an advanced micellar, oh gosh, I don't know, technique, meaning no two powders are exactly alike. And I don't know, I feel like it looks weird having this kind of pattern on packaging. I don't think it's very pretty. Like, this one looks dirty, the bronzer mix, and somebody said that the light one looks like bacon, and I can't unsee it. This looks like a raw piece of meat. Anyways, not my favorite outer packaging from them. I see what they were going for, but not my favorite. And these are a bit different than the previous palettes that have launched, which are like a heavy-duty plastic. These are metal. Can you hear that? They're like a nice, sturdy metal. And they open weird because this whole top comes off, whereas let me show you last year's. But you see that this part right here is part of the bottom and the lid is smaller than the base right here. This year's, and I keep trying to open them like the previous year's, but this year's, you see the whole top. Does that make sense? Are you picking up what I'm putting down? Anyways, also what's different about this year's packaging is it's a magnetic closure as opposed to a snap closure. I like the magnetic closure. I think it makes it feel more luxurious. Yeah, I mean, I'm talking in terms of just packaging right now, but you can see the differences in the packaging and how this is like metal. And anyways, yeah, different style packaging this year, obviously kind of same size though, so subtle differences, but I don't know, I just wasn't expecting it. Anyways, you couldn't tell in the pictures that it was this type of packaging. We are gonna first start off by taking a look at the lighter of the two. This is just called the Universe Palette. Like I said, these are $80 each. With each of these palettes, you are going to get 5 shades. So let's take a deeper dive into what these 5 shades are. So right here in the first place is a finishing powder, which is the Infinity Powder. Now this is a re-release. They launched this formula last year, and what it is it's 3 shades of the ambient powder in one: diffuse light, dim light, and hypnotic strobe light. Honestly, I'm not a fan of this powder. It's weirdly shiny on the face. It's like not shiny enough to be a highlight, but it's also too shiny to be a setting powder. So it's an awkward kind of formula. Not really a fan of this, and I don't think this sold well. So I wonder if that's why they put it in this palette. Just speculation. I don't know, but I don't like this powder. But the rest are brand new powders, never released from Hourglass. So this is the only one that you might already have in your collection. And if you don't, you're not missing out. So up here we have the Ambient Strobe Lighting Blush in Vibrant Heat. This is a vibrant pink, and the formulation, Hourglass uses a lot of the same words to describe their names and their formulas, but there'll be one subtle word kind of put in there to differentiate the formulation. So the strobe lighting blush means that this has a little bit of shimmer in it. Then we have, this is just the regular ambient lighting blush, so no strobe in there. This is Luminous Rose. It is a soft plum, and this one is a little bit more sheer, but it has some subtle glitter reflex in there. And then up here we have the Ambient Lighting Bronzer in Glistening Bronze Light. And then finally right here we have the Ambient Strobe Lighting Powder in Supernatural Strobe Light, which is a champagne color. So right now you guys can see on this screen close-ups of the swatches. Now with Hourglass, you will find that the swatches on them aren't very pretty. Really what looks gorgeous is when they are on the face, how they sit on the face. So I definitely want you to pay attention to the demo. We are gonna get nice and close. So in case you are wondering about anything that I'm wearing, it'll be linked in the description box. What I know you guys are gonna ask about on my eyes, I'm wearing the ColourPop It's a Mood palette. I'm playing with this for the second time and I really like it, you guys. It's such a good palette. I use most of the colors in this first column right here, and then I use this green as well, but anyways, that's what's on my eyes. It's stunning. Back to the good stuff. So I'm gonna demo for you the Infinity Powder for you. I do have a setting powder on, but this one I just want you to see. I'm gonna put it right here. So you see how that added a very subtle glow? So I wouldn't necessarily call this a finishing powder because it gets too glowy as you put it over the face. Instantly my texture was emphasized, and this is what I mean by it's an awkward powder because I think it looks terrible all over my skin. It doesn't blur anything, it just makes me look more textured, and honestly there's very 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 fine glitter particles, and it looks pretty right here as a highlight. I'm not gonna lie, it's really a subtle highlighter, and you can use a denser brush to kind of build it up, but I normally want a little bit more for my highlights, so I feel the need when I use this on the high points of my face to put an additional highlighter on top of it, which then causes it to lose its purpose. Not my favorite formula. Not really happy about them adding this powder, honestly. I would have rather them have added one of their normal setting powders, not this. Let's move on to the bronzer here. This is the Glistening Bronze Light in Golden Bronze. I've not tried this. This is a brand new bronzer. I'm using a Refer number 5 brush. Let me show you. Just dipping in here. This is pretty. Honestly, this bronzer can definitely work on medium skin tones. See, it has a really warm turn to it. It almost has some rosiness to it. So if you like a little bit of rosiness in your bronzer, this is gorgeous. And it's gonna look really good with a warm, toasty rose shade all over the cheek as the blush. Those two would blend together really nice. I like this bronzer. Honestly, I don't think I have a bronzer that's this color. So if you have a collection of the Hourglass bronzers, this is definitely a nice, unique bronzer shade. And it does give that slight sheen, so it's not flat, but Hourglass powders aren't flat to begin with. All right, let's play with the blushes. So I'm gonna start off with Luminous Rose because this one is a little bit more sheer. Let me show you. I'm gonna put this more towards the back of the cheek, and this blush goes perfectly with the bronzer in that it's that toasted kind of rosy tone. As per usual with Hourglass blushes, it applies beautifully. I don't see any glitter particles, just the beautiful luminous glow that Hourglass gives you with their products. Let me wipe off my brush. And now I'm gonna use the Vibrant Heat, which is that strobe formula. We'll see. Yeah, so you can definitely see this gives more of a glow to the skin than that first blush that we used. It is slightly emphasizing texture, but that's what you get when you use a luminous blush like this. And this is going to be a great gateway into the highlight. So I like that I use the plum shade towards the back to blend into the bronzer because the two undertones are very similar. And then this blush is great right on the apple to give some brightness to bleed into what will be our highlight. And as per usual, flawless application. Okay, lastly, let's get into the strobe lighting powder, which is Supernatural Strobe Light. I can see this has a little bit of champagne in it. I'm using a Refer 27 brush, which is an eyeshadow brush, but oh, that's beautiful. It has a little bit of a rosy turn to it. It's a champagne shade, but it's slightly rosy to go with the blush and bronzer. I mean, that's beautiful. The formulas in here aren't crazy metallic by any means, but they do have that soft luminosity that Hourglass gives. This is gorgeous. I really like this palette. Honestly, I like this way better than last year's. Let me show you last year's. This is the Lighting Edit Sculpture. First of all, look how light last year's is compared to this year's. But I will say, there was 6 powders in last year's and 5 powders in both of the palettes this year. I prefer the 6. I feel like the value is a little bit better, or a lot better. You get more colors, so I'm sad that they did that. As in terms of the color story, this one is way better. It's a little bit more versatile in my opinion. Right away, I like this palette better than last year's. But it's gonna get even better because I believe they've taken the feedback and they are going to cater to more skin tones by coming out with more than one palette. So I'm really happy to see that. So this is the Universe Unlocked. So the one with the unlocked word at the end is going to indicate that it's the deeper palette. And like I said, remember, this is that marbled print of the swirl textures of bronzers, as they say. And here is the back. And something I forgot to mention, I can't believe I forgot to mention this, but as every year, these have a 12-month shelf life and are made in Italy. Let's take a look at the colors. Now, this one has 2 re-released colors and 3 new colors. I wish they would just do all 5 new colors. I don't know why they want to go back. They do this every year. They always have colors that are in their permanent line in these palettes. I just want them to be all new. And with this one, unfortunately, there's 2 colors already in their permanent line and only 3 new shades. Here are the colors. So the re-released shades are gonna be the Ambient Lighting Powder in Radiant Light, which is a golden beige. And then this bronzer is a re-release, which is the Ambient Lighting Bronzer in Radiant Bronze Light. So these blushes, 1, 2, and the highlights are new. So take a quick look at the swatches. You can see that this one is definitely deeper. I think that the area of concern for this palette is going to be the bronzer. I am going to do a demo on this side of my face. Obviously, I don't expect this one to look as good as the other one because this palette, hopefully it's not made for me. I mean, that's the intention, right? The formulations are a little bit different as well. This shade right here, the Ambient Lighting Powder, they had that mixture in the lighter one of the 3 different shades. This is just a solid color, which I much prefer. So obviously these aren't going to look as good on me. I tested this on my mom before I filmed this so that I could give you a little bit more feedback on how this would work on a deeper skin tone. So my mom is NC40. She can go NC42 in the summer. So NC40 to NC42, I tested this on her. So I'm gonna tell you step by step how each color worked on her skin tone. So the ambient lighting powder, this was a beautiful glowy setting powder on her skin. If you use a less dense brush, this isn't going to give you that bright color that you see here. It disperses almost translucent and just gives a beautiful glow. So medium to tan skin, you're fine. But if you do want to, especially if you have a deeper skin tone, you can use this as a highlight by using a more dense brush and really concentrating the color in the high points of your face. You're gonna get more of a highlighter effect. So it is versatile in that sense. There are two blushes. They're both the ambient lighting formula. So in the lighter palette, there was a strobe blush formula that gave a little bit more glow. These are just the regular blush formula. Both of these, I honestly believe are going to work on deep skin tones. Very vibrant on my mom's face, both of them. They still blended beautifully. So this worked on her medium to tan skin tone. I think it's gonna work all the way down the line to deep. I genuinely do. These have a lot of pigments, and if you're on the lighter side, they will still blend easily because they are the hourglass formula. The bronzer, Radiant Bronze Light, I will tell you, this is the one that I wasn't too sure of. One of my mom's favorite bronzers. She already had this in a single in her collection. It looks great on that medium to tan skin tone. It pulls a very gorgeous golden color on her skin tone. I don't know about this on deep skin tones. I don't think it's gonna work, but I think it'll work up to a tan skin tone. All right. Take this with a grain of salt because I haven't tried it on a deep skin tone, but I know it works on my mom. And then finally, we have a metallic strobe lighting powder. There was not a metallic strobe lighting powder in the lighter palette. The metallic one is really good. I'm happy there's a metallic shade in here. So this is Solar Strobe Light. It's a metallic champagne. My mom was actually worried this was gonna be too deep on her. It wasn't, it looked beautiful on her, but I do think this is gonna work for a deep skin tone as well. In general, Hourglass's highlighter aren't too pigmented at the base. They blend out almost translucent with that glow and finish. So I think it's gonna work up to a deep skin tone. So point being, if you have a deep skin tone, I don't know about the bronzer. I don't think the bronzer's going to be the best, but I think everything else is really good. And I really do think that this is a versatile palette. I'm going to use it on my skin. It's not made for my skin, so I don't know how this is gonna look. I'm sure it's gonna look way better on my mom. But we're gonna start off with the Radiant Light setting powder. And you'll see this is translucent, so this is gonna work on me. And this looks way better than the setting powder in the light palette, if I'm being honest. It's hard to see because Hourglass isn't really about how it looks in camera. It's more so about how it looks in real life. That's where Hourglass shines. But this blurred the skin, added a nice sheen. I like this way better than the setting powder in the lighter palette that I tried. And I really do think this is a versatile color itself. It's gonna work on a lot of different skin tones. Okay, let's go to this bronzer. This bronzer is gonna work on me. I've tried it before. It's a nice bronzer, and the fact that it works on me should tell you that probably won't work on a deep skin tone. If you use a denser brush, I really believe this is going to fit up to a tan skin tone. Maybe on the lighter side of tan, but the thing with Hourglass is if the color is deeper, you can really blend it out to make it work for a lighter skin tone. That's really pretty. It doesn't have a rosy hue like the one in the lighter palette. Okay, the blushes. The blushes are gonna be interesting because these, I'm serious, are very, very pigmented. So we're gonna start off with Rose Heat right here, which is a deep berry. I'm gonna like tap off as much excess as I can. And we're gonna do the same technique where I keep this towards the back of my cheek. I mean, I went really light and that's very, very bright. I can make these work for me, I'm sure, but I will take a lifetime to get through it because you literally only want like 3 particles of pigment if you're light like me. And let's do this one. This one is a little bit less pigmented. This is Coral Flush, which is a bright peony. It's a little bit more suitable for me than that other one. But you can see my cheek is very, very bright with this one, and I was going very light. So can I make it work? Sure. It's actually really pretty, but it's brighter. If you don't like a bright blush and you're around my skin tone, maybe not for you. Okay, then lastly, we're gonna do the metallic strobe, which I'm excited about. I think this is gonna be too deep on me, but I want you to see the finish. Like, you see, that's metallic as opposed to this one. There's a very slight cast, nothing crazy. Like, I could go out in public wearing this palette, but this side looks better. This side looks more suited to my skin tone. This side looks good too. I gotta give credit to the Hourglass formula, the fact that this does work on me because their powders are so blendable and soft. But anyways, here's the two different palettes. I'm going to get myself together and I will share my final thoughts with you. So the next area that I wanted to cover are, what are the differences between these two? As you saw in the demo, there are a few differences in formulation here. I want to show you the side-by-side swatches, and you can definitely see that the Unlocked palette is deeper than the Universe palette, especially because of those blushes. Hourglass did a phenomenal job really differentiating the blushes between the lighter palette and the Unlocked palette. The only thing that I wish they would have changed is the bronzers, because I think the bronzers are kind of close. Let me do a side-by-side swatch. The tones are obviously different, but you can see on my hands here, this is going to be the lighter palette, this is the deeper palette. Obviously the tones are really different, but depth-wise, I would like to see a bigger differentiation in the depth for sure. That's the only area that they needed to improve. I don't know why they didn't do that. Because if this was just like two shades darker, it would have made all of the difference and made it very clear what palette was going to work for what skin tone. But that being said, I will say that when this is on the skin though, it does kind of adjust to your skin tone. So if you are a little bit deeper, it still will leave something there. It looks lighter than it actually is. But other than that, I think they did a good job. For myself and my skin tone, if you are similar, I definitely would recommend just the Universe one, the lighter one. This one is much more flattering on me. If you are a medium skin tone or up, I definitely recommend you go up to the Universe Unlocked. I think right at the NC38 and up, this is a good one for you. NC38 and under, this is a good one for you. And yeah, I mean, and if you're on the fence, you really don't know which one to get, I would say go with a deeper one, because you can make it work because of Hourglass's formulation and how flexible they are. Now, comparing it to last year, the Sculpture, I told you guys already, this has 6 different formulations. The ones from this year are so much better. I think if you have this one, I think that the new ones this year are different enough to justify having them. The blush colors are very different. The formulations are different. The bronzer colors are different. I don't think they're too repetitive in that sense, but these are better, like, if that makes sense. I'm just sad they don't have 6 colors. Anyways, I'm super happy with these. I think they did a good job. It was a step in the right direction. Now, let me know your thoughts down below. I hope you guys found this helpful to you. Thank you so much for being subscribed to my channel and liking this video. Your support does not go unnoticed. Seriously, those of you who comment on all my videos, I know your names. Don't worry. Until next time, stay tuned, because I have more holiday palettes and reviews coming. I will see you guys in the next one. Have a good one.